Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
I have overcome the world. And if Christ has overcome the world, we in Christ, with Christ, by the grace of God, we shall overcome the world in Jesus' name. But you know the truth is there, revealed by the Lord himself. Trials will be there. Persecution will be there. If you have just given your life to the Lord, and then as you go back home, you're going to find out, because your appearance will change, your language will change, the places you go, you'll not go there anymore, everything will change. And then you begin to carry your Bible everywhere you go. And you read your Bible, you love your Bible. And then people are going to notice. And first of all, they're going to tease you. They're going to ask questions. And they're going to be sarcastic about it. And they're going to be abusive, insulting about it. Get ready. That's the prize. That's what we get into. Because we identify with Christ. In the world, ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. And we look at Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14. Acts, chapter 14. From verse 21 to verse 22. And when they had preached the gospel to that city, and had taught many, they returned again to Lystra, and to Iconium, and to Antioch. They returned unto those places. And it says, they returned to Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch. You know, the Bible is wonderful. I said, the Bible is wonderful. You know, the people in the world, they can teach us theory. They can build up skyscraper. And yet, it's all imagination. There's no reality there. But look at this Paul the Apostle. Paul the Apostle, I'm going to back up now. And I'm going to read from verse 19. And there came thither certain Jews from Antioch and Iconium. Notice that, Antioch and Iconium. And it says, who persuaded the people, having stoned Paul, drew him out of the city, supposing he had been dead. You will not go through anything but near to this. The world is now civilized. They might just put down you. Some people might go further and ill treat you a little bit, just a little bit. They're not going to do something like this. Paul the Apostle in Antioch and Iconium, because of his stand for the Lord, they picked up stones. They stoned him. Real. Not a dream. He fell down. And they stoned him there. And when they looked at him and they thought he was dead, then let him alone. And they were told in verse 20, howbeit, as the disciples stood round about him, he rose up. You will rise up. I said, you will rise up. What can the world do until you finish your assignment the Lord has given you? Look at Paul the Apostle. And you know, we're going to the same heaven that Paul the Apostle went to. and they stoned him until they thought he was dead. And you don't want to stand a little insult, a little abuse, a little treatment, a little persecution. Nobody is stoning you. If he stood all that he went through, you will stand. And then it says, he stood up and he came into the city. And the next day, he departed with Barnabas to Derbe. And when they had preached the gospel to that city and had taught many, they returned again to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch, in the place where they faced the greatest kind of problem, persecution in their lives. They returned there. When we have the grace of God, you will return there. You will not say, I cannot go to that place again. I cannot do anything in that place again. There are souls there to be won. You'll come back. I said you'll come back. They were not afraid of the devil, and they were not afraid of the messengers of the devil. Verse 22, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. That's what we find on the way to heaven. And if we're going to go to heaven, going to get to heaven, there's no other way. The way that leads to heaven has persecution and trial and tribulation and difficulty on the way. But by the grace of God, we're going to go through. 1 Peter chapter 4, we're reading from verse 12. 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 12. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. So the forewarned is to be forearmed. The Lord is telling us ahead of time. Not everybody in the world will smile at you. Not everybody in the world will appreciate your rigid stance for the doctrines of the Bible. Not everybody in the world will appreciate your love for Christ. Not everybody in the world will appreciate your devotion to the Word of God. Therefore, persecution will come. Don't think it strange when it comes. The Lord has told us ahead of time. Then in verse 13, but rejoice inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. If ye be reproached, abused, insulted, assaulted, persecuted, slandered, if ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye, for the Spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you. On their part, he is evil spoken of, but on your part, he is glorified. You will glorify the Lord. 2 Timothy chapter 3. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12, yea, yes, truly, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Are you going to live godly? As you go back home, will you live a godly life? In your office, will you live a godly life? When they want to change the receipt, and they say, put your signature, will you cooperate with them? No. And if you don't cooperate with them, if you block their way, and you say, look at this man, look at this lady, Madam Jesus, look at her. She will not allow us to take the money, to steal the money we want to steal. They will not like you. You live godly in Christ. You're going to suffer persecution. If the people say, contribute money so that our market can sell well for idolatry, will you contribute money? No. Will they like you? No. Be ready for that. And after all, it's just a short time before love will be on the other side. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Maybe you say, things will change. The government is trying to eradicate corruption. And when they eradicate corruption, there will be righteousness. And then at that time, if I take my stand, nobody will oppose me. It will never be. The world is corrupt to the core. And the more the people of the world fight corruption in their own way, the more that corruption is increasing. Look at verse 13. But evil men and seducers shall wax better and better. What is it? If you think they are bad now, wait until next year. Evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. What are we to do? I said, what are we to do? Verse 14. But, tell me, in the midst of the persecution, in the midst of the distress, in the midst of the oppression, in the midst of the challenges, continue. And you know, there's some people, they're taking their stand, they're living the righteous life, they're following after the Lord. I've decided to follow Christ, no turning back, no turning back. Even though the world may be against me, still I will follow. No turning back, no turning back. The Lord is preparing another kingdom, I will be there, no turning back, no turning back. No friends forsake me. Still I will follow, no turning back, no turning back. And then a little fire, a little heat comes against them because of the decision they have taken. And then they are considering, I don't know what I'm going to do. I feel tired. I feel weak. I feel unhappy. I feel distressed. I don't know whether I want to go to church today. Get up and come to church, and the Lord will give you strength in Jesus' name. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. How do we continue? How do we have strength to continue in the evil days? Psalm 16. In Psalm 16, we're reading verse 8. I have set the Lord always before me. That's how to continue. When you see the Lord before you all the time, walking ahead of you, leading the way before you, you'll be strong. I have set the Lord before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Psalm 46, Psalm 46, verse 5. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The Lord will help you. Psalm 62, verse 2. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. Verse 5. My soul waits only upon God, for my expectation is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory, the rock of my strength. My refuge is in God. Trust him, trust in him at all times. When the persecution arises, trust in him at all times. Psalm 112, Psalm 112, 112, verse 6 and verse 7. Surely he shall not be moved. You will be moved. He shall not be moved forever. The righteous shall be in everlasting remembrance. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. That's how we get our confidence. Point number two. Confidence, the confidence of conquerors in the evil day. The confidence of conquerors in the evil day. Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Nay. What's the meaning of nay? That means no. Why this word no? Because of the answer to the question, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? And then Paul the apostle began to ask one by one, shall tribulation? Nay. No. Shall distress? Nay. That means no. Shall persecution? Nay. No. Cannot be. About famine? No. Nakedness? No. Peril? No. Or such? No. Nothing will separate you from Christ. Then it says, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ, through him that loved us. That's our confidence. There is a God in heaven who is interested in our lives. He is interested in our security. He is interested in our protection. He is interested in our preservation. And because of Christ, who sits on the throne and is watching over us and is interceding for us, that's why we have the confidence to remain a conqueror, and we're going to remain conquerors in Jesus' name. Psalm 27. In Psalm 27, reading from verse 1. Psalm 27 verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fail. They will fall. Before they get to you, they will stumble. Though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. You'll be confident. Because in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. For the weapons of